everyone. Welcome to Definition Ale. I'm Stephen Rich, and this is Real Beer. And this is Real Beer. Today I've got in front of me the Central City Red Racer IPA. In Ontario, the Red Racer has really taken the IPA scene by storm. This beer is brewed by Central City Brewing Company in Surrey, BC. They've recently, in the last few years, become exclusively available in cans. And recently, starting in about summer, spring 2011, the LCBO has been bringing in limited quantities time and time and time again. The demand has been fantastic in Ontario, and the LCBO, I expect, will continue to bring it in, and maybe one day we'll get lucky, it'll become a regular release. And deservingly so. This is one of the highest rated beers on the internet from Canada, which is fantastic. It's a 6.5% India Pale Ale. The description on the back of the can goes on and on about the English voyage to India, their traditional English style IPA, but with the kind of hops that are in here and at 6.5% and certainly around the 50 to 60 bitterness unit range at least, it's certainly leaning more towards the American style IPA. But let's open it up and see what it looks like. Already, I'm really in love with the density of the head that's being created here. It's incredibly tight. It's this nice kind of creamy, slightly off-white color. And then the beer itself is beautiful golden orange, exactly where an American-style India Pale Ale should be. Oh, it's just terrific looking. Really magnificent. Yeah, that really is beautiful. The body is almost completely transparent. There's a slight haze going through, which leads me to believe that this beer is unfiltered, which is exactly where I want it to be. It is this striking golden orange, kind of bright caramel and yellow color. Just perfect. The head, as I mentioned, is incredibly tight. The top of the foam is very sticky, well structured, very kind of foamy and marshmallowy cap. Beautiful. Oh, yes. The aroma is blatantly American. It's this beautiful cross between sweet pine and sweet sugary citrus. Yeah, I mean, it's got those traditional kind of grapefruit zest and sweet pine characters, but it's very, very aromatic. It's not blasting me with bitterness in the nose. It's really fresh. It's really juicy and sweet on the aroma. And just the pine and citrus mix is nice and complex, but easy to enjoy on your palate. A little bit of malt shining through, a little bit of kind of caramel honey sweetness, a little bit of grainy character as well, but in general, lots of pine, lots of citrus. On the nose, I'm getting lots of grapefruit and almost that orange peel character as well. I'm digging in. Oh, yes. Oh man, so 6.5%, I don't know the bitter units, but I'm going to guess between 50 and 60, really sensational. Those first sips come across very quenching, very smooth and elegant across my palate, and bringing in with it really matched at the same rate. I'm getting smooth kind of caramel, grainy, biscuity malt notes, but lots of hop character. And the hops are flavorful and aromatic, not piercingly bitter. Yeah, all that pine and zest comes right in a smooth balance all the way across my palate and then floats in through the back of my cheeks. It's showing me a good sensation of spice as well. Nice kind of earthy pine sensations, like if I went into a pine tree and just like grabbed some needles off and crushed them up in my hands. That's what I'm getting out of here. The grapefruit isn't overwhelming. It's actually this nice kind of balanced citrusy and zesty character. Anywhere from grapefruits to oranges, a little bit of tropical sensations in there too, maybe papaya and mango, not so much on the pineapple. I better test it one more time. Oh yeah. The spice, ooh. That time the spice really hit me in the front. Really nice melange, really nice kind of array of hoppy characters that I'm getting from this beer, but it's totally sessionable. I'm gonna pound this glass so easily and need another can of this. It'd be great if this came in a large size format, like a 750ml bottle, because this beer is designed to be shared. I want all my friends to enjoy this because it's got beautiful character. Enjoying this with food is gonna be great too. It's gonna just dominate spicy food. All that spicy, citrusy, and zesty, and piney hop character is gonna cut right through spice, cut through heat, cut through fatty foods. It's gonna match perfectly with charred and grilled foods. Parmesan cheese is gonna be great with this. Stinky and washed rind cheeses and creamy cheeses are gonna be fantastic too with this. Cheesecake as a dessert would be great. I can even see chocolate going really well with this because there's a lot of fruity sensations in the hop character. I mean, a really fantastic beer. I'm having a hard time figuring out all the terrific things I want to say about it. It really has me breathtaking. I took this can about out of the fridge maybe about 10 minutes ago, so it's cool, not quite ice cold. And as it's warming up too, I am starting to get a little bit more malt character out of there as well, but the hops aren't going anywhere. Oh yes. If you're at an LCBO and they don't have the Red Racer, talk to your manager and ask them to bring it in. Hopefully they will. The more people that do this, the better a chance we have of getting the Red Racer as a regular listing at the LCBO, which it deserves to be. Thank you, Central City. Cheers.